hit the subscribe button and press the bell button for more videos.
Was just found on another dead body. Information hounds have their paws deep in the dirt as they dig up ghosts of Hillary Clinton's past and search for any and all evidence linking her to the death of a prominent figure in American history. Truth seekers look for evidence that could lead to her to indictment and incarceration, but those who seek are coming up with mixed results. The hottest trending controversial conspiracy slithers back into relevancy in the wake of JFK's classified files being released, even though numerous items were redacted. This theory plots Hillary Clinton against JFK Jr. and suggests that she's directly, or indirectly, responsible for the plane crash that left JFK Jr. and two others dead, thus paving the way for Clinton to win an easy seat in the Senate and further her career. Look back to 1999 when numerous New York residents fancied JFK Jr. the front-runner in the Senate election taking place in the year 2000. A young charismatic man like his father, JFK Jr. would have had an easy victory over Hillary Clinton if he had run for Senate in 2000, but any possibility of him entering into the election was halted midair with the crash of the aircraft he was in. A midnight flight and an unfortunate demise of a budding personality who could have carried on the legacy of his father had it not been for that harrowing flight that ended it all. Many sources say JFK Jr. was not 100% set on running for Senate, but if he did, it would have been an overwhelming victory. Sources like Your Newswire point to Hillary Clinton as the reason JFK Jr.'s plane exploded and crashed. The website suggests that Hillary had no intention of returning to Arkansas and her only goal was to win a seat in the New York Senate, no matter what it took. The source allows readers to believe, without truly saying so, that Hillary Clinton was responsible for the murder of JFK Jr. based on the details of the event, in which it's believed that JFK Jr. was flying the plane in the nighttime and he had called the radio tower for something, then randomly exploded. One has to wonder what caused the explosion. The website then discusses the possible events that suggest the Clintons covered this up very quickly by preparing a Navy funeral service, even though JFK Jr. did not serve in the Navy. This all happened after a search located JFK Jr. and his passengers' bodies in the water. The source states the following has occurred. At 9:20 p.m., July 16, 1999, John Fitzgerald Kennedy Jr. radioed the tower at an airport near Martha's Vineyard, Massachusetts, announcing that he was preparing to land. Seconds later, his plane exploded in midair, the explosion witnessed by several people including a local newspaper reporter and an attorney. Luggage was recovered miles from the crash site, an event that can only be caused by a midair explosion. 5 hours after the plane went down, William Bill Clinton sent out the equivalent of the Sixth Fleet to find the wreckage, hide it and the bodies from the snoopy media, and though JFK Jr. was never in the Navy, and though the families did not consent, he ordered the cremation of the corpses and threw the ashes into the sea in a hastily arranged Navy funeral. No photographs were permitted of the recovered bodies. Kennedy's emergency locator was removed, the cockpit recorder was disabled, and the flight log was taken, all of which is documented in the official investigation report. Behind the scenes, a cover story was concocted. The weather, which was perfect, somehow became stormy. JFK Jr. now had a gimpy leg, and Kennedy was emotional. Reports by the FAA and FBI, both concluding foul play was involved, were buried, and all inquiries led to dead ends. In truth, all reports confirm that JFK Jr. was emotionally stable and a highly skilled and careful pilot. The Kennedy family was furious, New York was heartbroken. All evidence had been destroyed or burned by executive command. "She killed him, I know she did," said a Kennedy staffer who asked to remain anonymous. The Clintons bought their home in New York, formed the Clinton Foundation, and Hillary won her Senate seat. Even the liberally biased website Salon published an article that provides similar insight into the possibility of Hillary Clinton being involved in the death of JFK Jr., but without any true evidence, there is no way to prosecute anyone. Salon's article talks about Roger Stone and his desire to publish a book discussing Hillary Clinton and JFK Jr. It's important for readers to gather their own information and do their own research. Always keep an open mind to the possibilities that are out there, but always remember that every theory is considered a theory until concrete evidence is brought forward. Readers must be responsible and search for evidence that turns the theories into truths. Discuss them with friends, hunt for information, and present fact-based argument for the theory you're looking to prove or disprove. We must remember that anything unproven requires facts to be proven. Find the facts and you'll have your answers.